I'm going to show you a really, really good place to farm runes in the early game in Elden Ring. You'll be able to get almost 200,000 runes per hour. But I'm going to show you the method and the science and everything to make sure we get this right. Also going to show you how to get there and stuff. It's a crazy rune farming spot. You'll be able to get here right out of the gate, basically. As soon as you get your horse, especially, you can just run over to this place. There's a teleport. You get to an end game zone, and there's enemies that are kind of annoying to farm, kind of easy. It depends on how you go about it. Depends on what you have available to you. If you've already played some and you have a good weapon that will one-tap these guys with backstabs and things, it'll be great. If you're actually level 1 out of the gate, it's going to take a little bit of prep work of, you know, a tedious farm at first. You get a bunch of levels, and then it's really easy. So I'm going to show you how this all works. It's a really good rune farm. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to a certain place on the map. This is called Third Church of Marika. It is right here in relation to the starting area. This is where you start. This is where the Third Church of Marika is. There is a teleport right near this that will take you over to the Bestial Sanctum. So the fast travel or the teleport is just outside of this church. From here, you're going to get on your mount or not get on your mount. You're going to head right out here. So we're in this place looking at the Grace statue over there. You can jump out right through here. It's not the only way to get out, though. You go over here, though. You're going to head just basically northeast of this big old broken cathedral thing. Northeast in this little swampy area. You head back here, and there is one of these. And if you interact with this, it'll ask if you want to teleport to another location. You say yes. This will take you to an extremely high level area, a really high level for the start of the game, but this will get you there right away, real fast way to get to a high level zone. This will take you over to Grail's Dragon Barrow. So on the map, now we are all the way up here on the map, really far. Saves you a lot of travel trying to find your way over here in the beginning. And then from here, we could farm some real high level stuff. And the other one they're going to need is down this path. Now, I'm going to go around this eagle guy because I don't want to fight him yet. That's actually a boss. That's not a statue. So we're going to head down this way. You're just going to follow this path. And at the end of the path, you'll have a grace. And there are certain enemies around here that we're going to be farming. And we're showing you a route to farm. And also, there's some things you need to know. So the first thing you need to know is we're going to be doing a backstab method. You're going to need to get used to not locking on to enemies. If you don't lock onto them, you can, even at like level 1, it's really easy to kill these guys. The other thing that you're going to need to know is at first, you're not going to be able to get the full amount per hour. Although here's the grace, by the way. I'm going to show this on the map, actually. So the two sites of grace over here are there and there, right by the bridge. So at first, you're not going to be strong enough to... oh my god, the screen graphics problems, holy cow. You're not going to be strong enough to one-tap these guys. Also going to wait till daytime and make it stop raining so that graphical glitch will stop. Okay, so I just can't get the rain and the graphical glitch to stop this time no matter what. I tried everything. It has to rain here. So we're going to go on. It's very easy to die to these guys on accident when you're lower level without enough HP, without enough armor. So at first, it's going to be rough until you level up or get some better gear. But generally, you're just going to get off your mount. You're going to run around them. And you're going to try to spin around them. I cannot get a backstab to work. There we go. And you're just going to try to backstab them over and over again. If you're not locked onto them, you can just walk around them. And then just backstab them over and over and over again. If you're low level, it's extremely dangerous. These guys can, like, one-tap you, basically. Oh my god, I just can't... Oh, the backstab mechanics are so weird on these guys. There we go. And so you just backstab them repeatedly. This is what you're going to do at first until you can get a way to be strong enough to one-tap them. So one thing that you can do is you can get the golden halberd from killing the horse boss in the beginning. If you want to see how to kill him or a guy need help on killing him, I have in the description of this video a guide for killing the horse boss, how to do it cheese strat and how to do it the right way and just fight him. And once you get something like this, what we can do here is we can keep on... killing these guys and leveling up and then spending our runes on whatever attribute we need to get whatever weapon we need up. If you have any other tools you want to bring to the table to get to where you can just basically one-tap these guys or take them down real fast, you can go ahead and feel free to use that. In my case, I'm going to sit here and I'm going to level up my strength, my dex to 14, maybe my faith to 12, and then my strength to 30 so that I can wield the golden halberd correctly and then just backstab with that. But generally, you're just going to go from enemy to enemy to enemy and hope that you don't mess up on accident and get one tapped. And then once you... oh my gosh, I can't. Once you... there we go. Once you are strong enough to just really beat them, that's when we're going to be looking at a... man, those guys hit hard. And they are so hard to backstab. It's so hard to backstab. Once you're strong enough, then you're going to want to do the actual farming route. But that's what you're going to do right there. They're going to be really weird to get used to. Once you get used to them, it won't be so bad to backstab them. They give a ton of runes. You're going to level up, get strong enough to really take them out. And then we're going to be looking at the route. If you're not strong enough to just get them in one backstab, there's a trick you can do to make it a little bit easier. If your weapon's strong enough, you'll be able to do this and it'll be easy. If your weapon's not strong enough, it's going to be rough. So until you get to where you want to be or find a weapon that you like that'll work, this will kind of work, but you really need a weapon to be just strong enough first. So you actually go behind them and sneak up and backstab. You'll do more damage than normal and weaken them enough. Now, if your weapon's strong enough, you can follow up with a flurry of attacks and then get dodged and look like an idiot. Anyway, if you didn't dodge that last one, you would just finish him with that combo with this weapon in particular. But you can just do this while you're grinding for whatever weapon you need in order to one-tap them. But ideally, we're going to actually sneak up behind them like that and just go for the one-tap. So you see them from a distance. You want to come in from behind them always and then just come up behind them and get one free backstab. And that will make your grinding a lot easier until you can just one-tap them with that sneak backstab. And then you can get them like that, hopefully. And that will help you level. But ideally, you just want to get them you want to sneak up behind them and just get them with one backstab. But you're going to need a really strong weapon to do that, like a strong two-handed or an enchanted weapon that has bonus damage. You need something. You need something to really make that happen. But that is what you're going to be doing along the way. At first, as you run around, just kill these things, trying to get levels needed in order to really farm them. Okay, I'll be honest with you, that was a grind, but I came into this without the right equipment. If you already have a good two-handed weapon that you can use that'll one-tap these guys or be close to one-tapping, or you got some magic spells that you use that make it easy, use a bow, whatever makes sense for you to farm these guys. These guys, if you try to get them with a weak melee weapon, I'm not going to lie, they're a nightmare. It was actually hell at first until I got strong enough to get them with one sneak backstab and then slash them down before they could react. Once you get to that point, it gets a little bit easier. But these guys are still insanely annoying to deal with, okay? So be prepared for some frustration. I definitely felt some. But we got that out of the way. I now have the weapon from that horse boss in the beginning of the game, the Tree Sentinel. I have that weapon maxed out now. I have it to where I can actually use it, and it just barely one-taps them if I sneak up behind them and stab them. So now, with that being said, I'm going to show you the route that you're going to run. I'm going to time it. I'm going to show you the first loop of it, and then after that, I'm going to run it for 30 minutes with a timer. In order to see how many runes in this game. How many runes do we actually get per hour doing this? So that you guys will know. And yeah, let's check it out. So what you're going to do here, starting from the, not bonfire, the whatever they're called. I forgot the name of them. The Farm Great Bridge right here, the Grace. All right. So you're going to run here. There's a guy on the right. You're going to try to see from a distance which way. All these guys, you're going to try to see from a distance which way they're facing. And if you have any problems with one of them, you're just going to generally say screw it and just go on to the next one. If they troll you, you just got to let it go. It's already kind of a bad cycle. Both of them are coming on. I'm coming in from facing them. So we go up to this one and one tap them. So that is what you want. Once you get the horse's guy's weapon, the Sentinel Tree's weapon maxed out, you're good. So from here, we're going to head over to the northeast. There's a guy right here. He just turned around, so I actually have to go back the way I came. It's really hard. You got to keep an eye on him. And then we're going to come in behind. Okay, well, sometimes they're just total assholes, I'll be honest with you guys. But I did that right, and he just turned around anyway, which it happens like one out of four times maybe, where if you're just like, don't come in perfectly behind them, they just turn around for no reason. But it's fine. If that happens, you just skip. It's not worth the time. So this is a bad cycle, a really bad cycle so far, but it's whatever. You'll have that over the course of the runs. But you see, once you get this down, it's real fast, especially if you get lucky and they're facing a good direction for you. Yeah, I was going to pillage that, but I know they don't actually have anything too crazy. Like, this guy, again, this is such a bad cycle. That guy's facing such a bad way. I have to go all the way around. And then he just turned around anyway. Literally just randomly turned around. All right, terrible. God-awful cycle so far. Literally the worst I've maybe ever had, but we're still doing. This is also why I'm going to do a 30-minute run of this after this initial run, which I'll just skip through so you guys don't have to watch me do this for 30 minutes. And I will do that so we can get a better estimate of what you'll actually get by doing this for more than just one cycle. So also I've noticed a trick is if you're on the horse when you come up behind him, apparently the horse is basically sneaking at all times. So at this point, this is the end of the cycle, and now you're just going to go back down to the start. I've tried a bunch of different cycles, and this is the one that I've decided I like. It kind of takes me in a loop and will get me a decent amount of shards every so often. So then you're just going to reset it, and then we're going to head back out. I'm just going to repeat this process now. All right, I did that for right around 30 minutes, and I was able to get... I already had 10,000, so I was able to get around 90,000 runes in half an hour. Now, you know, your mileage will vary depending on how you kill them. If you have some better way to kill them where you don't have to sneak up behind them to one-tap them, you know, you might be able to get 400,000 maybe even. Who knows? I don't know. Maybe you could find a different way to route them that would work better. But if you did it the way that I showed you and you have a weapon that can basically one-tap them with a sneak backstab and you get good at it, then we're looking at about 180,000 runes per hour. And again, you can just come here right away. Let me like reiterate where this is on the map. So we're all the way up here, but it was from this church right here. So you start up here, you get a horse, a gate front, and then you just go running all the way to the third church of Marika. There's a portal there. It'll take you up here to Bestial Sanctum. And from there, you can just farm endgame stuff like real easy. So it's pretty good. 180 runes per hour. That was enough for me. Not per, yeah, 180 per hour. But I got 90,000 in 30 minutes. So in 30 minutes, that's enough for me to go from level 31 to 42. So, you know, in 1 hour, you could go from 31 to 50 probably. And then if you grinded it for like 3 hours, you could be like level 70 already. So you could just like start your game, and in like 3 to 4 hours, you could go from level 1 or 2 or 10 or something all the way to level 70. So it's a pretty crazy farm, honestly. So that's the rune farming spot that I have. Hopefully that helps you out. Now you know a good place to farm runes in the early game. I'm sure there'll be something better that I'll find late game. And if I find something really good late game for your new game plus saves and different stuff, I'll post about that too, so consider subscribing for that. But that is it for this video. Now you know a really good rune farming spot in this game, way up here, using a teleporter at the Third Church of Marika in order to farm 180,000 runes per hour in Elden Ring.